Essays by Francis Bacon. Of Studies by Francis Bacon. Summary, Analysis and Important Quotations. Hello and welcome to The Discourse. We are discussing the works of Francis Bacon and today we will begin discussing his essays. First, we will discuss an overview of his essays, which was his first published book. Then we will go through some of his most famous and important essays, which are important not only because of the deep knowledge they contain, but also because often questions are framed in various competitive exams, including UGC NET English Literature, which are based on these essays. We will offer thorough summary and analysis of each important essays by Bacon, and in the end of the summary of each essay, we will conclude with some of the very important quotations from that essay that can be directly asked in exams. So let us first begin with the book essays, Religious Meditations, Places of Persuasion and Dissuasion, Seen and Allowed. It was published in 1597, and it was the first published book by Bacon, which contained 10 essays on varied topics. The topics ranged from private life to public issues. In each of the essays, Bacon offered contemplation from different viewpoints, arguing against each other, while giving reasons why and what is the correct viewpoint, covering the topic in wholeness. It was the first edition which was repeated in 1612, and the second edition contained 38 essays. In 1625, Francis Bacon published the third edition of his essays by the title Essays or Counsels, Civil and Moral. The third edition contained 58 essays in total. Francis Bacon is known as the father of the English essay. Let us begin with one of the most important essays, which is titled Of Studies. It was one of the first 10 essays by Bacon published in 1597. Of Studies by Francis Bacon, Summary and Analysis. The theme of this essay by Francis Bacon is the importance and benefits of studies in an individual's daily life. Often people suggest that instead of giving alms to a poor kid, it is better to help them in attaining proper studies so that they can improve their own abilities and make an honest, honorable living. That is, rather than catching a fish and giving it to someone as charity, it is better to teach him how he can catch his own fish. Let us discuss the summary now. For Bacon, study is always related to application of the gathered knowledge through the studies in practical life. Francis Bacon begins with discussing the three major purposes of study. Bacon says that there are three important purposes of studying. Studying for gaining delight, for ornamenting one's life, and to improve one's ability. One can study some comic book for entertainment with no other practical purpose. Some people study not for making good use of the knowledge that they may attain through the studies, but for the purpose of showcasing their studies as a standard or ornament. They showcase their knowledge, how much they have studied, and get delight in that. The third kind of student or people who study are those who study to improve their abilities. Francis Bacon then compares a wise, experienced man with a learned man who studies a lot and suggests that an expert man with worldly experience can carry out plans and judge a particular circumstance. However, those who study are better than such a worldly man in understanding important matters, giving advice, and knowing how to deal with daily affairs in an optimal manner. So, according to Bacon, only a learned man can manage daily affairs and issues expertly in an optimal manner to lead a healthy and stable life. Bacon then proceeds with the advice that one should avoid excessive reading and suggests that too much studying leads to laziness. One should also avoid showing how much he read too much, as it leads to affectation and he starts showing off what he has read to impress others, rather than making any good use of his studies. He suggests that too much reading can be addictive. Too much reading books may diminish the line between book and reality and may lead the reader away from the real world, and that can be harmful. Here Bacon suggests that studying not only include reading books, rather it also includes reading nature, surrounding and real circumstances. Bacon says that the act of judging a particular situation based on theoretical knowledge alone, without applying the practical learning from the real world, is not correct. Bacon suggests that there must be an equilibrium between book reading and practical learning. Here, one may remember what Ralph Waldo Emerson suggested about bookworms in his essay, The American Scholar, that we discussed a few days ago. Francis Bacon stresses on the value of practical knowledge. Bacon says that studies are useful only when our bookish knowledge is supplemented with the practical experiences, because while the natural abilities of a person are like a plant, nurtured and enhanced by studies that act as a fertilizer, but without practical experience, studies lead to confusion in dealing with the outside world. Therefore, for Bacon, the study is always fruitful when it is applied in practical life. He further says that a wise man is always willing to implement all the knowledge he gained through books into practical life to experiment and decide whether the knowledge he got from a book is practical or not. Bacon again discusses the real purpose of reading and suggests that one should not read only to sharpen his arguments to defeat his opponent or to show off their ability in reasoning. One should also not read because they believe that reading always leads to correct behavior or understanding, because it may not be true. Lastly, Bacon says that one should not read merely to attain ability to deliver an impressive speech in conversation with others to impress them. Instead, Bacon suggests that the real purpose of reading and that of studying should be to sharpen our faculty, understanding and judgment to improve our abilities. Bacon then delves on how to read different books and says that some books are meant only to be tasted. Books for entertainment, like fictional books, are meant only to be read lightly, and one should avoid delving in fiction too much, as it would lead to confusion between real life and fiction. Some other books are meant to be swallowed. Books full of philosophical knowledge needs to be read carefully and wholly. Theoretical books should be read not with curiosity but with purpose of memorizing them, so that one may use the knowledge gathered for practical purposes. He further says that some books are meant to be chewed and digested properly. One should read scientific book with great diligence and attention to understand it perfectly and to extract permanent benefits out of it. Also, even some fictional or philosophical book can be so good that it may become necessary to read it thoroughly and with great diligence to extract the real juice of that book and attain benefits from it. It is unto the individual to decide for what purpose he is going to read a book, what kind of book he is going to read, and then apply the proper way of reading that book. Bacon again suggests that studying is not only reading. He says that reading makes a full man, conference leads to a ready man, and while writing makes an exact man. What Bacon means is that reading makes us analytically better being, but when we use the knowledge gathered in our discussions and conferences, it helps in improving our intelligence and sharpen our intellect. But when we begin writing based on the knowledge gained through our studies of books and practical life, then we become the exact man, as it improves our memory and makes us sharp-witted. It should be noted that speaking about a subject doesn't allow us enough time to contemplate before speaking, and it may lead to wrong expression and or statement. However, when we write, we express our refined and exact opinions and feelings. After proper contemplation and hence, we reduce the chance of making any silly mistake in expressions. Thus, writing exacts us. Samuel Johnson also mentioned and supported the same distinction between reading, writing and conversation in his own essay on studies, which he wrote in 1753. The central theme of Samuel Johnson's essay is in fact this point of Bacon, and he gives reference of Bacon saying, "It is observed by Bacon that reading makes a full man, conversation a ready man, and writing an exact man." Bacon also says that reading a complementary book or reference guide for the main book can be a better option, but not in case of important books. Also, reading a summary or reference book is often tasteless. At the end, Bacon suggests that one should not confine themselves in a narrow stream of particular subject of books. Rather, they should read all kinds of books, as histories make men wise, poets witty, the mathematics subtle, natural philosophy deep, moral grave, logic and rhetoric able to contend. Bacon says that there can be no problem of mind of an individual which cannot be solved through studying, as studying is the solution to all the problems a person may face. Now let us see some important quotations from Of Studies. The first one is, "Studies serve delight for ornament and for ability." In this quote, Bacon is mentioning the uses of the purposes of study. We have already discussed this. "To spend too much time for study is sloth. To use it too much for ornament is affectation." We have also explained this quote in the summary. The third quote is, "Crafty men contempt studies, simple men admire them, and wise men use them." Bacon is saying that cunning men often criticize studying as they don't want others to get benefits of studying. Simple people, on the other hand, love studying. However, a wise man is that who not only studies, but also make better use of his studies by improving his abilities. The fourth quote of Bacon from the essay Of Studies is, "Read not to contradict and confute, nor to believe and take for granted, nor to find, talk and discourse, but to weigh and consider." We have already clarified this quote in the summary. The fifth quote is, "Some books are to be tasted, others to be swallowed, and some few to be chewed and digested." The sixth quote is, "Reading makes a full man, conference a ready man, and writing an exact man." Samuel Johnson used this quote from Bacon's essay in his own essay On Studies, which was published in 1753. Seventh quote is, "Distilled books are like common distilled water." In this remark, Bacon suggests that while it may be beneficial to read complementary books or summaries or reference books of the main book, but reading a summary or distilled book is tasteless and insipid. Eighth quote is, "Histories make men wise, poets witty, the mathematics subtle, natural philosophy deep, moral grave, logic and rhetoric able to contend." Bacon suggests that one should read all kinds of books, as different kinds of books helps a person to improve different abilities. So this is all about Bacon's Of Study. Students preparing for UGC NET English Literature and GATE English Literature should keep all the eight quotes in mind and should remember that these are from Francis Bacon's essay Of Study. We will come again with another essay of Bacon. Please stay with the discourse. Thanks and regards.